The defender in its base form, for me, is the my preference. For this particular version, which is the Explorer pack,
okay,
you know, has all these features on it, which are great because there are people that are going to want this type of accessorization. You know, you got the side ladders, you got the roof rack, and in fact, you can put a tent up on that roof, because that roof will take something like I think it's about 300 kilos in weight, so four adults basically. It's got protection on the wheel arches for when you go off road. It's got snorkels on the front. It's got the this one hasn't got the impact bar on the front, but it's got a lot of features on it, and it still works with the overall design, which, you know, as I explained, is a modern interpretation of the original, but quite different.
What about some of the design, the lines? Which ones were carried over from?
Nothing is carried over.
Nothing.
When I say pay homage, what I'm talking about is, you know, when you look at the silhouette, you can see there's a reference there to the originals, like, you know, the shape of the wheel arches. But this is a thoroughly modern vehicle. It's not, there isn't anything that's carried over from the original vehicle.
So from the early day with a clean sheet, what was the first thing that came to mind?
Well, we don't just work from a clean sheet.
Oh, you
don't. We have a design strategy. And the first thing we have to do is design it to make sure this has supreme all-terrain capability and also optimized proportions. Number one prerequisite for a good design is optimized proportions, and that's all about getting the wheels in the right place relative to its overall length, height, width, etc. And remember, we were designing a family of these vehicles, three-door version, five-door version, and there will be more to come.
Now, would you, being the Fenders, the Halo product, would you not want it to be less of an everyman's car?
Well, it's not that Defender isn't the Halo product. You know, in our brand, they're equal. Land Rover is a master brand. You've got Range Rovers, you've got Discoveries, and now you have a family of Defenders. But they represent different values and appeal to different customers. Having said that, there may be customers that have Range Rovers and Defenders. So it reinforces what Land Rover are about in terms of their supreme off-road capability. But having said that, a Range Rover is equally capable off-road. Not as severe, because this has the minimum overhangs, the high breakover angles that give you that sort of supreme all-terrain capability. But it, you know, it's not just about that. When you look at the different versions of the car, you look at the Urban Pack, you know, that vehicle arguably won't be taken off-road very often, but people would buy that because they just love what it represents. So I think the car will appeal to a diverse group of consumers.
Do you find that even harder, a bigger challenge, to design a car for a wider potential group of group of buyers?
Not really. I think the trick to that is design something that has the ability to change its character while still maintaining its overall design and engineering integrity. And this design does lend itself for it to accessorization. You know, when you see these different versions, as I say, this is a country. Mm-hmm. When you look at the Urban, well, it's not over there, I don't know where it is
there.
Now.
Yeah.
It's much cleaner. I mean, personally, my favorite will be the first editions, which is a very clean, that's what you start with, where it's just pared back and represents part of that modernist design philosophy that we have.
Okay. All right, thank you so much. Thanks, Gary.